Hello guys, welcome to CRNT Designers, Chetan here. In this tutorial, we are going to make a sci-fi art with the help of only simple cylinder. So are you excited for it? Yeah, definitely. So let's get started. Wait. Before moving toward the sci-fi art, if you didn't subscribe my YouTube channel, then please subscribe it and turn on the notification bell icon. And now, let's move toward the sci-fi arts. Let's get started. So add a cylinder. Bring it little bit up, then go to edit mode, and we need to create such kind of slant cut. So take a knife tool and select your first point, then press Z, select your second point and press enter. So in this way you can create the slant cuts, and it's very easy. Okay, you can create the slant, such kind of slant cuts as many you want. Select your first point, then press Z, then select your second point, and then press enter to create such kind of slant cut. Okay, so here we have done the slant cuts. Now select those slant cut and add deselect that top edge, and then select those slant cuts means edges and add a bevel on it. Give the proper amount for that bevel. 0.005 will be fine, and then extrude those bevels faces inside. Okay, it's look pretty well. Add a bevel modifier, give the 0.005 amount and change it to the angle. Okay, now we need to shade smooth this. Then please shade smooth it before going to the edit mode and turn on the auto smooth. After that, select these faces, press Shift Alt to select in this way such faces, then select these faces from the both side, that side also. You can see it's look pretty well. After that, insert these faces and give the proper amount, then extrude inside those faces. Now one more time, we need to insert these faces. I is a shortcut key for that. Insert these faces and extrude outside these faces, and it's look pretty well. You can see we have got the desired result right there. Okay, what next? We need to give the proper amount for their extrusion. Now here I have tried one different way, just I tried to scale it down but it not works. Okay, fine. The next thing, go to the edit mode, select these faces. You can select, I think the four faces are pretty enough for that particular, create the box kind of look. So select these four faces from the both side, so you can see like there. Okay, then insert those faces. After that, extrude inside those faces in this way. One more time, then insert these faces, give the proper amount for your extrusion. Okay, insert those faces, then one more time extrude those faces outside, and it's look pretty well. Select these faces. Now don't select all the faces together, select those faces and then scale it down little bit to achieve that bevel kind of look, and it's look pretty well. Do the same process for all that rectangular boxes. The next thing we need to do is very simple. What? Go to the edit mode, select the top and bottom face and insert that face, and then extrude inside that face. I have select only top faces. Then one more time select that face, insert, then extrude outside and scale it down little bit. Insert that face one more time like this and extrude inside that face to achieve the desired result. It's very simple. Now insert it one more time and extrude inside that face. One more time insert it. Try to adjust its height insert one more time, then extrude outside, and this time add a bevel on it. It's very simple. And increase its segment. 7 will be the fine amount. 7 segments are fine. You can see it's look pretty well. Then scale that segment edge a little bit and select that face and insert that face and extrude inside that. So here we have got the proper shape. Select the bottom face, insert that bottom face and extrude inside that bottom face. And it's look pretty well. Now the select these faces, you can select all the faces together. Shift select and then insert these faces in this way. Now one more time insert these faces, but this time select outer, check mark the select outer. So you can see we need to give the different image and shader for those rectangular shapes. Okay, because we want to create that sci-fi look. So that's why we need to give the different shader for those rectangular shape. Okay, select these faces and then insert these faces and this time deselect the select outer and check mark that individual. And after that you will get this result and then extrude those faces inside. It's very simple. Now we need to add 3 loop cuts, add a bevel on it. After adding the bevel, select these faces and extrude inside those faces. In this way. It's very easy. Now what we need to do? Model is look pretty well. You can see it's fine. And the next process is UV unwrapping. Okay, so what we need to do for UV unwrap? Go to the UV editor tab and then go to the edit mode. So you can see now I'm in UV unwrapping tab, but we don't need to UV unwrap this model because we have created this model with the cylinder, and cylinder is always in UV unwrap. So we don't need to UV unwrap this model. Then go to the direct to the shader editor, and you can see change it to the material preview, sorry for that I have already given the image and shader, so I need to delete that image and shader. Now we need to create a different texture for our model base color, so that way the black metal texture increases metalness, decreases roughness. It's very simple. So here I have one metallic texture, I will use that metal texture. So add that texture, connect to the mix RGB and add a black color to that particular texture because I want a more black texture. So you can see I have added that texture, metal texture. Okay, then add its normal map, add its bump map, go to the vector, then add a normal map, connect to the normal map, input that texture and connect that the normal map output to the input of the principal BSDF, normal input of the principal BSDF, decrease its strength, so you will get something like this. After that we need to add a bump map, so we don't have the bump map, so I will add vector, then bump map node, then connect the base color output to the input of the height input of your bump map and connect the output of your bump map to the normal input of your principal BSDF and connect the normal output of your normal map to the normal input of your bump map and decrease its strength. So you can see we have got the pretty well texture right there, and it's look pretty well, awesome. The next thing, we need to create one more texture. So select these faces and we need to give the different texture for these faces. Select these faces, shift select and press alt particularly to select these faces in the loop. Then deselect these side faces Okay, after that we need to add one more texture for this, and that will be the complete black texture. Okay, so select the faces in this way, add a complete black texture. So we need to create one more texture, so create one more texture that will be the complete black texture. In this texture just we need to give the more black color, and we need to increase its metallic little bit and decrease its roughness little bit, then we will get the black texture, complete black texture. You can see I have increased the metalness little bit and decreased the roughness little bit, so I got something like this. Okay, now I need to add the emission shader somewhere in those loops. Okay, in those gaps I need to add the emission shader. So I have already selected those faces. Let's insert those faces. This time uncheck that individual and then add a different emission shader for those loops. You can see in that gaps, so it's look pretty well. Now we got that sci-fi feeling for our model. Then select these loops. You can see the rectangular loops which we have created already. Select those rectangular loops and add an emission shader to those loops. Now our model looks pretty well. So do the same process for other three loops also. You can see now we have got that sci-fi look for our model. And I need to add one more texture, that will be the black rubber texture. To create that black rubber texture, I need to UV unwrap my model, not the whole model but just only these faces. So I have selected these faces. You can use the shift select these faces, and you can press the alt to select the loop like this. Press a shift alt and select that loop. Select those, just accept those faces which we for those faces we have applied the emission shader, blue emission shader. So don't select those blue emission shader faces. Okay, and now give it another texture, that will be the black rubber texture. And we need to UV unwrap these faces. So for that, UV unwrap smart UV project. Okay, it's look pretty well. Now we have successfully UV unwrap only those faces. Now we need to create the another texture, rubber texture. So for that I have already one rubber texture, so I will use that rubber texture. So here you can see, here I have rubber texture, base color, bump map, roughness and the normal map. So add a bump map, base color. After adding the base color, connect its base color output to the input of the principal BSDF, then add a normal map, connect the normal map, then decrease the strength. Then we need to add a bump map. You can give the proper strength for your normal map. Okay, like this. Then add a mix RGB because I want the black color rubber, so that's why I have added the mix RGB. I have mixed both colors together. Okay, then add a bump map. So this is the roughness, so just connect that roughness map, the roughness input of your principal BSDF, then add a bump map and connect it to the normal map in normal input of your principal BSDF. Okay, like this. And then connect the base color output to your height input of your bump map, and we got something like this, which is well. Just decrease the strength. Now it's look pretty well. And connect the normal map output to the normal input of your bump map. And we need to give the different color for these rectangular faces. So select these rectangular faces like this and give its different color, that will be the black color. Okay, and select the top face and give its emission shader and you can see our model looks pretty well. Then we need to create a studio light setup. For that, add a plane. I have already set my camera in proper angle, and for that I have used the third rule. You can use also that third rule. So that's why I'm rotating my model a little bit and rotate that background plane, and then go to the edit mode, select that top edge and then extrude it. After extruding edge, select that the middle edge and add a bevel on it and increase its bevel segments and shade smooth it and give it different texture. That will be the little bit gray color, but that the dark gray color. Okay, and it's look pretty well. Then I have already added the HDRI changes color management to the high contrast. I didn't add any light because this is the sci-fi art and that sci-fi model already have the emission shader, so that's why I didn't add any external light. Change the render engine to the cycle and you are ready to take the render. And our model looks pretty well. So here we have successfully done this sci-fi art. You can see the final output of this sci-fi art. So if you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you so much once again, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.